Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden. In this video, we're going to create this broken glass effect with text. Now, I've already prepared the text here. But it's important for this effect that the text needs to be outlined. So after typesetting, so after we've got the text, you need to go to type and then create outlines. Otherwise, this won't work. So let's go to this again. And we are going to use Pathfinder functions for this. So we need to work precisely. In order to achieve that, what you need is go to View and turn on Snap to Point and also turn on the Smart Guides. Like so. Then in this artwork, you select the center point for your breaking glass. So in the case of glass, it's the point where the ball hit the glass and where you've got the center from which all the shards explode. So in this case, I'm going to put it in here into the punch of the A. And what you then do is take the line segment tool and then you can draw the segments. So from here you draw the segments, and it's better to apply a color to the stroke like so, and then you can draw. So it's better to meet this point, but you can't with the selected line do it because then you grab the line. So in order to meet it, you draw the next line like so. You start from here and go to there and again like so, so that they meet. Now you need some more lines. You need a lot more lines. And when drawing them, always take care that they meet. So in the case of this, it's not necessary that they meet because it's outside of a letter shape. But when it's inside, they need to meet. So you need to make sure in this case, for example, and you see the highlight of the smart guide. So there they meet. And then you can draw a lot of these lines. So in order to shorten this procedure, I have prepared that already. So let's get rid of the blue ones. I'm going to select one of them and then go to select same stroke color, and then let's get rid of them. And in the layers panel, you see I've already prepared that. This is how it looks. So that's a nice mesh of these lines. You actually don't need a lot of them because the text will explode in a lot of parts, and that's just sufficient. So like so. And then what you need to do is just select all of this. And you see this is actually, so this has no effect on anything. We can also get rid of that. But then let's select all of them and go to Window and Pathfinder, like so. And then you go to Divide. And you see you have some nice pieces. What you also have is some parts that you don't need. You see here outside, this is not logical that that one is there. So let's first go to ungroup, and then you see this part that shouldn't be there. It has no fill and no stroke. So we can assume that there are some more of them. So let's go to select same and then fill and stroke and select all of these invisible parts because we don't need them, just get rid of them. And then the next thing you do is move these apart. So you take them and then you move them. So this might take some time depending on how many letters there are. You can also rotate them slightly, but actually that's not needed. You don't need to do that. So in here, this happens because something didn't really meet. So in the case of this one, this would need to be inspected further and then split up more precisely. So let's take a look at this one. Maybe we can use the Shape Builder tool on this. You see, just click here, and then we have also separated those. And then you see, you can move these. And again, with this one, this is just a path. So let's take the Shape Builder tool and click on here, and then we can separate it. And you see, this is all you need to do then to get this effect. Like so. Move these apart, maybe rotate it, and then get your effect. I'm not going to finish that. Let's take the last step. And the final step is we're going to take the gradient panel and apply a gradient. And I have just selected this default gradient, which has some transparency in it, which would be suitable for glass, but you can also create this without transparency, of course, and with just a lighter blue in here, and just click on it to apply it to the fill. And again, this is kind of regular, so you can select some of these and then just rotate this gradient slightly to get slightly more regularity into it. So in the end, you are left with that one. So that's how you can create the broken glass effect easily. If you like the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.